What's good today? I got a review of Nioh 2. The other day I finished it up and I didn't really expect to enjoy this game as much as I did, but I fucking loved it, so I want to go ahead and do a review of it. So I guess I'm going to go ahead and get right into it, but it's a pretty good one. First thing, this game looks amazing. Everything about it looks insane, which is one thing that kind of pulled me into it. I didn't know what the demons were, but I found out that they were just called yokai. And that this game is set in a time period that I'm really into, the warring periods of like Dynasty Warriors and a lot of other things kind of follow this time period. So they took that time period and put the little yokai demon spin on it, and it's fucking awesome. I love the whole lore of it, and I love how everything about it is. I didn't go the deepest into it. There's a lot you can really dig into and dive into if you want to do a lot of reading. I did a little bit on some of the yokai I really liked, like Otekamaru and Kasha and some others, but I didn't do every single one of them. The ones I really got into were mostly the big boss monsters. The story in this game is just enough to keep you entertained. It's really not that insane, but it does have a little bit to kind of keep you going and kind of make you want to pay a little bit of attention. But it's not the most insane. It's like your best friend, you and your best friend are trying to save the yokai, and then your best friend gets kind of corrupted, and then you have to kill him, and then bada boom, bada bing, you know what you're doing. You're chosen, you gotta save the world. It's pretty basic, but it's also cool at the same time, especially when you're just demon slaying. One thing I really like about this a little bit more than Dark Souls is that the weapons in this game really take a little bit more life into them, and that's a little bit literal and metaphorical. The weapons look a lot cooler, and they actually can be a yokai themselves, and they can actually talk to you. It's not really a big play in it, but it's really cool just every now and then that your sword will just start talking to you. The combat is very Souls-like, but it has its own twist. It's got stances on it, which I like and dislike at the same time. I pretty much played the whole game in high stance mode, I'm not even gonna lie. But the thing about it is sometimes it'll get kind of clunky when you're playing, and there's a lot of buttons that sometimes you got to keep up with, especially with menus, stances, yokai mode, and the yokai activate, yokai shift, and all that other shit. You got a lot you got to keep up with, but also at the same time it still works. It's really cool for what it is, and I do enjoy it. I enjoy the variety, but at the same time I think maybe if it were to strip away maybe one layer of it, it would be right at the right amount, because right now it feels just a little clunky. On the other hand, if you are to pick up to everything and kind of understand how everything works and make everything flow right, you can kind of just slaughter and dominate everything. So it's kind of like a weird thing. On one hand, sometimes it feels really clunky, and on the other hand, once you got everything flowing for you, you're really just kind of slaughtering like an amazing, awesome, unstoppable samurai. So I really don't know how I truly feel, but like I said, I like it and I hate it at the same time. Where I think the game shines a lot more in the Souls series is the bosses and enemies and whatnot. With the yokai demons and everything, it makes everything a lot cooler, even human enemies like Nagamasa Zai and Magoichi Saika. They really make human enemies a little bit more alive and a lot more than just, I am really good with a spear type shit. Some of them are pretty boring still, and some of them you still have to fight without the yokai, and then they get it later. But overall, I think the bosses are awesome. There's not one that is like a clone or whatever. There's even two that look the same, Mizuki and Gozuki. But even they kind of have their own ways about them. Even when you fight them together, they don't feel like you're just fighting clones. They feel like they're a little bit different from each other, even though they're kind of like twins. So the bosses are pretty much what the game really wants to present itself. And it kind of feels boss rushy. But it isn't exactly. Some of the levels do go on a little bit, but it adds to the little bit of the story and the lore. But overall, it's what the bosses are what you're after here, and it does not disappoint once at all. Especially with the bigger bosses like the Owl, the Tatakamaru, or whatever, something like that. All of them are really awesome. None of them are repetitive, and even when you fight the same one later in the game, you're like, heck yeah, because it doesn't like it's not like it's been happening over and over. It's pretty cool. I love the bosses in this game, and that's what shines in it to me. The level design is kind of weird to me, because on some of the last levels are really cool, like the Mausoleum of Evil. It's really awesome looking, and everything looks amazing, and all through the game everything looks cool, But except for these fucking volcano levels, them are kind of just shitty looking. And if you have your brightness down like a little too low, it's kind of hard to see goddamn shit. But overall, the game looks great. But the level design is kind of whack, except for the last few levels. And even then, some of them are kind of hard to navigate through. And it's just kind of whack sometimes to play through it. But overall, it works and there's fun. It's fun to play through it and just slaughter through the enemies. One last thing I want to talk about is how the game is kind of set up. The game is sectioned off into missions. It's not one seamless open go-through, kind of like Dark Souls is. I like how Nioh does the game, though. I like how Nioh has it sectioned off into missions, and let me tell you why. I have a kid, and I don't always have the amount of time to go through and play it like a Dark Souls game would be, where it's kind of long between bonfires and it's really kind of hard to find a safe spot to do something if your kid is getting into shit or if you got to go do something. You know, I like how Nioh has it set up. It still has shrines, but you still kind of get that breather time to kind of take care of life if it happens real quick in the map world. And Nioh, I could see it being kind of seen as the easier one of the Soul series because of types of stuff like this. But I also think it makes it a little bit more accessible to people who want to play games like that too. And I'm not saying it like I haven't played Dark Souls. I enjoy Dark Souls, but I also think I feel like I flow more with Nioh simply because I can play it a lot easier, not the game itself, but being able to play it, if you know what I mean. I think I can access it easier because of the map stuff and the accessibility rate of it, you know? I enjoy that. I prefer it, and I think that would help people get into Nioh as well. But, you know, like I said, I think some people might see it differently. But, you know, like I said, I enjoy it, so I don't give a damn. What do I give Nioh 2? I give Nioh 2 a 9 out of 10. I think it does what it's trying to do very well. And I think maybe most of the problems may be my own, like, player issue, you know. I think, like, maybe some of the system, like I said, once you get past a lot of it, it becomes very rewarding. But I think when it comes to, like, most new people, I think when they come up with the amount of buttons they got to deal with, they're like, wow, that's a lot. I was like that, but once I got past it, like I said, it rewards you hard. So, 9 out of 10 for Nioh 2. I very much enjoy it. And if you watch this review, thank you very much. And take it easy.